Have you joined the Happily Ever After Club?
Happily Ever After Club?
Haan, Happily Ever After Club. Membership is automatic once you buy your dream home from Amit Inamdar. He's both real estate and mortgage broker. One stop, no need to shop.
Oh, Amit Inamdar from Own Sweet Home?
Yes, that's Amit from OWN Own Sweet Home. Call him today, 510-364-6686. Again, 510-364-6686. Or visit ownsweethome.net. That is OWN Own Sweet Home. .net.
DRU number 01355522 and MLS 236574.
Hello, welcome Power Hour listeners. This is RJ Renuka. Today we have another exciting show with Amit Inamdar. You are going to get the power pack 30 minutes of information on what sellers need to know while evaluating an offer. What an awesome topic he has chosen today. We always welcome you to text us at 415-234-HOME to get your question answered on the radio. And for past radio show archives, just go to Amit's website, ownsweethome.net. Hey, and you can always find Amit Inamdar just by searching his name on Google. So, let's hear more from Amit.
Hey, thank you, Renuka. Own Sweet Home. Hello, friends. Welcome to my show, Power Hour with me, Amit Inamdar. Today, we are going to discuss various aspects of evaluating buyer's offer on your home that is for sale. At the end of the deal, all you need is one buyer who has closed the deal on time on the price and terms that are acceptable to both of you. Okay, so remember, it's not always about the money, except when it is, right? We have done past shows on the one thing that every seller looks when selling a home, and that one thing is the emotionally and financially strong buyer. Today we are going to dig little deeper and see how does one reach a decision to sell to a particular buyer. Price and terms of the offer both matter depending on your specific situation when time comes to accept an offer.
Yes, and that day will come and it will be wonderful, fulfilling, joyous. Do a happy dance and when you receive an offer or in a situation of, you know, multiple offers for your home. The questions you are going to face that may not have surfaced before may start popping up. How do you know if an offer is the best for you? Do you accept, reject or counter the offer?
Yes, and we are here to help. Having worked with you from beginning, we understand your financial goals, time constraints and emotions involved in parting with the place you have called home many years. As I indicated before, price and offer terms both matter depending on your specific situation. What good is the highest offer when the settlement times are long and buyer has right to back out? You will be wasting your time, and after buyer backs out, you will be back on the market. The property that comes on the market does not always come with the same enthusiasm as it did when it first hit the market. Buyers think something is wrong with the property and they may lowball, and not only you have lost time in the process, you may lose money too. In other cases, the highest offer buyer may want you to move out immediately and that may not be convenient to you. So, speed over price against price over speed may be a decision maker in these cases.
So listeners, what Amit is suggesting is one buyer's beautifully written offer might not look so good anymore. When we work with you, we have the sense of what you want financially and personally, and we can help you determine whether offer at hand satisfies those goals.
As a part of negotiations that we do, we know your needs and wants. Needs are non-negotiable and wants are things that are nice to have. So various aspects of prospective buyer offer must be known upfront, and we should have a plan to confidently select a particular buyer and their offer. Just like we interviewed you, Mr. Seller, and discussed your needs and wants, we check with buyer's agent what their buyer likes about the property and what are their concerns that may need addressing. This helps us develop a strategy when time comes to negotiate an offer. Is the buyer emotionally excited about the home and the neighborhood? Is their motivation to buy the home stems from a good schools, the views from the property, the location, and something else? You know, we are going to do our job to help you negotiate terms of, and the price of the home so you have a strong buyer who can close on time.
There are various aspects to preparing your home for sale as well as accepting the financially strong and emotionally committed buyer for your home. Amit has a really good resource for you to see. It's the 7-step smart move program that allows you to get top dollars for your home in any market.
You know, we are going to discuss some of the aspects of the online webinar today. So listeners, if you are thinking about selling, call me for comprehensive advice that will save you money. You may have questions on the process of selling. I have a great webinar for you to see. This webinar covers all 7 steps of selling a home to get most of the investment you already own. You may have questions on whether to buy first or sell first. I can meet with you face to face, analyze your assets, debts, finances and home equity and guide you. I do both loans and real estate, and using my extensive knowledge, I can guide you through the often confusing and hard decision making process. I also provide a free room by room review and show you the upgrades and improvements that will bring you more value for your investment. Pinpoint price analysis I provide is based on your home condition and market dynamics. You know, my sellers always come out ahead when they work with me. Just visit my website and request access to this comprehensive system.
So listeners, you are listening to Power Hour with Amit Inamdar. If you have any questions regarding loans, real estate or today's topic, which is what sellers need to know while evaluating an offer, you can Google Amit Inamdar and you will be able to get to Amit's website and also find his contact information. It's Amit Inamdar, Real Estate Broker. So Amit, can we summarize the top 5 things other than the price that seller must consider when evaluating an offer?
Sure. You know, when vetting offers, the areas that one should evaluate are buyer's earnest money deposit, the contingencies, the buyer's down payment, the condition of the home, and contract time frame. We are going to discuss these one by one. Once you understand these, you will know why your first instinct is just to accept the highest bid that is on the table may not be the best instinct. After we have gone through the time-consuming process of setting your listing price, preparing your home for sale, staging, promoting your listing, and preparing for open houses, our efforts should be rewarded. And that reward shows in the timely closing the deal on price and terms that are acceptable to you. The offer that comes in may not be perfect. However, if we follow the process of negotiations, we should be able to develop a counter-offer process that achieves that goal.
So, let's start with the buyer's earnest money deposit, or in short, EMD.
EMD, yes. You know, the size of EMD, which is earnest money deposit, and the time to deposit that money in the escrow are very important factors to protect against buyer's remorse. First-time home buyers may think they made a hasty decision. Maybe they overpaid for the home. That is why seller accepted their offer right away. You know, I mean, when the offer doesn't get accepted, they're worried that then if the offer is not getting accepted, when it gets accepted, they think they overpaid, right? That's where the buyer's remorse comes into play. The EMD is the initial deposit buyer is willing to put down in the escrow when the agreement is signed to show their seriousness. Someone may offer $1,000 EMD on a $1 million home, and others may offer $20,000 or $30,000. You know, the larger the size of the deposit, serious is the buyer about the property. Mode of such deposit also important, like wiring the funds, writing a personal check, or bringing in a cashier's check to the escrow. I have seen situations where buyers will put a stop payment on their personal check and back out. I have seen buyers not depositing any funds in the contractual time frame, which is like 3 days, for example, you know, typically. So as a seller, you need to remember, if the buyer backs out of the contract for no good reason, you have right to keep a buyer's deposit as liquidated damages. So higher the number, better for the seller in terms of closing on time as well as receiving some kind of a compensation in case they back out.
So just like the size of the EMD, the earnest money deposit, size of down payment is also a good indication of seriousness of the buyer and ability to get the loan.
Absolutely. So each type of mortgage requires certain minimum down payment and certain minimum credit score. Even though certain loans can be done with lower down payment, typical rule of thumb is to have higher down payment for a stronger offer. Let's say, start with an example, right? So you have multiple offers on the house. To simplify, let's assume that all the offers are at $1 million. Only difference is the size of the down payment. The six buyers you have range from 5% down payment, 10%, 20%, 30%, 50% down payment, and there is one all cash offer. All other terms being equal, you will accept the all cash offer. If there is no all cash offer, you will accept the offer with the highest down payment to avoid any loan qualification issues. Also, large down payment is a good hedge against the shortfall in the lender required appraised value. Or there is a situation where a low down payment buyer is paying $50,000 higher than the rest of the offers. You know, here you can actually use my loan expertise and I say, oh, he's a low down payment buyer, but he's going to pay extra $50,000. Can his loan be done? And if that's possible, we may actually accept that and get extra $50,000 for your home. It's also possible to counter a low down payment buyer knowing that they can get a loan with higher counter offer and non-negotiable terms. And these are advanced strategies we use to net higher for our sellers. And that requires knowledge of the loan process, which you know many agents do not have.
Sellers are at additional special advantages as Amit evaluates these buyers financially and finds ways to net more gains on your sale. All cash offer may look attractive at first, however, there may be some considerations where the offer may not go through.
All cash offer means buyer does not have to go through the lender required appraisal process. It also means deal can close quickly. Deal has fewer ways to fall through as there is no appraisal requirement. However, beware, all cash offers does not mean the greatest thing all the time. Availability of the buyer funds in the US currency, also availability of the buyer funds in the United States is very critical because fund transfer may take time. Sometimes the large sums of money may not have same easiness for transferring across the borders. So just do not get carried away with all cash offer. When you hire us, all these worries are addressed and we help you get that peace of mind. We are going to take a short break and we'll be right back.
Own sweet home, own sweet home. I dream of my own sweet home. Right here, right now, Amit Inamdar will show you how. Call Amit and you are set. Or just visit ownsweethome.net.
DRE license number 01355522 and NMLS number 236574.
Welcome back, friends. This is Amit Inamdar, and if you are in the market to sell, buy or finance your home, you will get unbiased advice that will save you money. And that is my promise to you. To get hold of me, just Google my name, Amit Inamdar, Real Estate Broker, and you will know ways to find me. Having all your questions answered at one location and by one person means saving time, money and having peace of mind that you are being cared for by someone like me who knows this business. Today we are talking about what sellers need to know when evaluating buyer's offer.
So Amit, we have a comment from Sandhya on our 415234 home number.
Mm-hmm.
Sandhya recently sold a home and says she was disappointed that her agent did not know the negotiations options, so he didn't tell her either.
Mm-hmm.
So she is saying just by listening to the introductory part of your radio show, she sure thinks that they would have gotten better representation from your team.
Hey, thank you, Sandhya, for the kind words. You know, selecting the right agent to sell the most valued asset that you own is a very critical part. No agent can promise you the price. Our job is to effectively market the property to get the higher demand, which in turn leads to the highest price. Okay? So we bring the market to you and the market determines the price. Also, both buyer and seller needs and wants analysis is critical in making sure all negotiations are win-win and all parties feel that they got a great deal. For specific questions, just feel free to call the same number, the 415-234-HOME, and press 0 to talk to me. Also, let me have Renuka tell you about the home seller webinar to help people like you and others, the resources that we have that will educate you upfront before you jump into the agent selection process and what needs to be done. Because if you do these things while in the process of selling, you are going to make mistakes and you may not have enough time to correct those mistakes and you may overspend. You may not know all your options. So this particular webinar is designed to give you all the options and educate you upfront.
So the webinar Amit is talking about is available on Amit's website, ownsweethome.net, that is ownsweethome.net. If you don't remember, all you have to do is Google Amit Inamdar, real estate broker, and you will get to his website. The home seller webinar will guide you through the 7-step Smart Move program. The Smart Move program is designed to get the top dollars for your home. Remember, there is no exact price for real estate. The price is where buyers and sellers agree on. Question is, how do you make buyer to agree to paying higher? This is where home pricing skills come in. This is where home marketing skills come in. And this is where negotiation skills come into play. You have heard this again and again. Amit is certified real estate negotiations expert. So the 7-step Smart Move program takes advantage of these negotiation tactics as well as all the preparations required for a successful sale, including home pricing and aggressive marketing. The strategy at the heart of Amit's program is greater exposure leads to a greater demand that in turn leads to higher price. So homeowners, if you are interested in knowing more, just call Amit and request access to this comprehensive system. Home seller webinar is a must for every home seller, especially if you are a first-time home seller. And as I said, the webinar is available on Amit's website, ownsweethome.net, ownsweethome.net.
So one of the things Renuka just said, that there is no exact price for real estate, is so true. I mean, how do you know whether to pay $20,000 higher or $20,000 lower, you know? And that's where we are basically use our negotiation skills, use the information that we gather from other agents, and use that information for the benefit for the client that we are representing. Okay, so let's now start with the other offer terms that are like contingencies. Okay, so contingencies are good for buyers. Okay, however, may not be as good for sellers. Okay, so most offers will have contingencies. These contingent conditions must be met before the deal closes. Otherwise, the buyer is entitled to walk away from the deal with their earnest money. Contracts with fewer contingencies are more likely to reach closing in a timely fashion.
So Amit, what are the common contingencies that sellers should know about?
You know, the contingencies that buyer put in the contract, that's what the seller should be aware of, because they are the ones that are giving the buyer right to back out, right? Uh-huh. And walk away with the money that they have put in the escrow. So the 5 most common contingencies are the property inspection contingency, loan contingency, appraisal contingency, seller disclosure contingency, and sale of buyer's current home contingency, so they can buy your home. Okay, unless they sell their home, they cannot buy yours because they need funds to close. These contingencies are standard in every contract except for that last one, which is common in the strong buyer's market. However, remember that all these contingencies are negotiable in terms of time and the penalties associated with that. How you negotiate them effectively so the deal closes on time is where our expertise comes into play.
So listeners, you are listening to Power Hour with Amit Inamdar. If you have any questions regarding real estate loans or today's topic, it's a very interesting topic Amit has chosen today. What sellers need to know while evaluating an offer? You can reach us 415-234-HOME, or you can call or get hold of Amit just by searching his name on Google. So Amit, let's get to the next one. you know, the home inspection contingency or the property inspection contingency, which gives buyer right to inspect the property condition for its suitability. You know, property may have extensive termite damage and buyer inspections may reveal that. Property may have non-working appliances or HVAC systems, and inspections may reveal that too, because, you know, lot of things are unknown. Maybe leaky roof, standing water in the crawl space, and mold in the attic may cause buyer to back out as well if they have property contingency.
You know, and any of these surprises that may happen during the contingency period may impact sellers' net profits. If such items are found during the contract period, seller may not have much negotiations power and may end up spending more money on repairs. I say more money because you don't have time to shop around. You are against the contract deadlines and you will have to kind of do those things as required so the deal closes and buyer is happy. Repairs may be structural defects, building code violations or safety issues. Some inspectors give very detailed and easy to understand reports and others have lengthy descriptions without specific severity rating for the repairs. So we help sellers avoid surprises and recommend inspectors and quality repairmen so they can save money in that process.
So another contingency is appraisal contingency, which allows the buyer to back out of the deal if they think they have overpaid, or, you know, they may negotiate the price down to as low as appraised value. So appraisals are done by licensed appraisers. They are opinion of a value of this licensed individual. Appraisals are typically done by lenders to protect their money, and in case of buyer default, they can sell the property and recover that money. And
right. Also, if there are offers without appraisal contingency, meaning say buyer is agreeing to pay for the home, say let's take an example, like they are just agreeing to buy the home for $1 million, and even if the appraisal comes in 900K, he is still going to buy it. So at that time, in situations like this, it is critical to evaluate buyer's excess funds to cover for the appraisal shortfall. Seller may be entitled to the deposit, however, critical market time will be lost in selling the property. So it's not about you are after the buyer's $30,000 or 3% deposit. Your goal is to actually get the property sold at the highest price to the emotionally and financially strong buyer. So appraisal contingency or not, the situation does need further evaluation for smoother closing.
The next contingency is loan or mortgage contingency, which allows buyer to walk away with their earnest money deposit in case lender rejects their loan. Loan can be rejected for various reasons depending on the lender, you know, underwriting criteria. Buyer losing their job, not having reserve funds, just like appraisal contingency. Buyer unable to have the tax and income verified, and you know, there are so many other factors that involve in the loan and mortgage contingency.
Right. And all today's, I mean, it's like all the jumbo loans requires anywhere from 6 to 12 months of reserves. If you have lower down payment, it may require 18 months of reserves. So the thing is, the lenders want to make sure in case you lose your job, you have the funds to cover for that time period. And sellers need to be aware of a difference between a pre-approval and pre-qualification. They are not the same. Buyers and many agents do not know the difference. It's always a good thing to verify that the letter you have is a pre-approval that has verified the income, credit and job of the borrower. Lot of headaches can be avoided if you know these and some of other things, and you will know those when you watch that particular webinar.
Inspections, you know, they give a snapshot of the home condition at the time of the inspection. However, seller disclosures that provide buyer with the history of home condition may allow them to walk away from the contract. Also, undisclosed items may come back to haunt you even though the deal may close, and we're talking about the sellers today.
Right. And we explain your role in the selling process. Your desire to help buyer may become a liability down the lines because you will disclose something new and the buyer has right to back out because it's a critical information that you forgot to disclose in writing. So complete and thorough disclosure is very critical. Something you left out and disclose later allows buyer to walk away from the deal.
And another important term of sale is the closing date. This is when the sale officially closes. Buyer owns the home as a new homeowner and seller receives their funds. It is a critical date and any changes may affect buyer and seller and can cause monetary damages.
You know, seller may want to rent back from the buyer after the close. Seller may be agreeable for a longer close. However, buyer may relinquish their deposit and buy a better deal, leaving you hanging dry with their deposit, right? Which you got, but your house didn't sell. So longer escrows are not good. So it is critical to view the big picture and close the deal first as the priority number one. Longer escrows are undesirable, like I said. 30 days is a very common escrow period here in the Bay Area.
As Amit mentioned earlier, depending on your needs and wants, we will negotiate the deal. Rather than rejecting offer, we may help you get what you need by the process of counter offer. Every transaction is different and experience counts.
Yeah, of course, the experience always counts.
Yeah.
Okay, and the counter offer that we'll prepare that will address both your needs and wants, which are wants are like negotiable, but needs are not, right? So at Own Sweet Home, we have combined experience of over 36 years between Renuka and I. For each transaction, we talk to 43 different people from 14 different industries to complete 7 stages of a successful transaction. We have to see the situation know how we will help to maneuver you successfully once we are working with you.
So thank you, listeners. Hope you learn a lot today how to evaluate buyer offers. It's not always about the price. It is also about the terms of the offer that makes a successful close.
You have a wonderful weekend. Happy buying, happy selling, happy financing, and Own Sweet Home.
Own Sweet Home, Own Sweet Home. I dream of my own sweet home. Right here, right now, Amit Inamdar will show you how. Call Amit and you are set. Or just visit ownsweethome.net.
DRE license number 01355522 and NMLS number 236574.